Conditions allow us to display content on our terms. Only show boxes when you want, to who you want. To whom you want? I don't know. This isn't a grammar lesson. It's a lesson about conditions. To add a condition to a box, click on the Add button from the dashboard. Or go to the Conditions tab in the editor and click Edit Conditions. Click on that big green Add Conditions button and then click the Add New Rule button. Now we can choose a condition from the drop-down menu. Try not to get overwhelmed.
Or mad with power.
Let's start simple. One of the first reasons to set up conditions is to test a Lightbox before it goes live. We can limit it to a single test page instead of publishing it site-wide. To do that, scroll down to the URL section and choose Current Page URL. We can choose from a list of operators, but let's stick with Contains. In this field, let's put ? Lightbox test. Now when we add that to the end of our URL, that's our unique test page for this Lightbox. We can add multiple conditions to the same box. So let's say we want a Lightbox to appear only when a site visitor is browsing on mobile. We can add a rule for that too. Add a new rule, scroll down to Device, and choose Device Type. By default, it's set to Equals. We'll leave that and choose Phone. Now this box will appear on a page that has Lightbox Test in the URL, but only in mobile browsers. Now let's add a delay to our Lightbox. That way, when the user visits the page, they can browse for a few seconds before getting hit with a pop-up. So let's add a new rule. Scroll down to Time and choose Total Seconds on Page. Let's keep it set to greater than, and let's go with 3 seconds. Now our Lightbox will appear after we've been on the page for at least 3 seconds. With conditions, we can display boxes on one very specific URL, such as yoursite.com/product/denim-jacket/UTM_campaign=featured. Or we can display a box of multiple pages that contain the same characters. For example, on our site, every product page contains product as part of the URL. So to show a box on every product page, we can just add a condition that says current page URL contains product. Now every product page will show this Lightbox. But let's say we also want it to show up on category pages. That's easy. Change the operator from contains to contains any of these. Now we can also add category, and the Lightbox will show up on product pages and category pages. So now we know where and when to show boxes, but when should we not be showing them? Well, you probably don't want to show newsletter signups to anyone who's already on your list. To do that, we're going to use the Pages Navigated condition under the URL section. The exact way to set this up might look different for you, so we're going to give you a really common example. If your email newsletter uses the UTM code, UTM medium equals email, then this example is perfect for you. So in this case, if we set Pages Navigated URL to does not contain UTM medium equals email, this box will only show for users that never clicked through from one of your emails. We can also show boxes based on a user's cookies. That lets us show boxes based on things like whether or not they're logged in. Let's show a box asking users to log in, but only to users who are not currently logged in. To do that, we need to add a new rule. Scroll down to Storage and choose Cookie. You need to know a little bit about how your website uses cookies. For example, we'll go with logged in for the cookie name and false for the value, but your website might use different cookies. Now, when a user visits our website and they're not logged in, they'll see this box. Think you know everything you need to know about conditions and you're ready to close this video? Wait, don't go. We haven't even told you about exit intent yet. With exit intent, we can display a box anytime a user moves their mouse cursor towards the edge of the window. By default, exit intent is set to mouse exits window top because most users will mouse up to the address bar when they want to go to a different website. This is a great way to entice visitors with a really good offer before they go. A little side note, because there's no mouse tracking on mobile, you can set your mobile Lightboxes to display after the user has been idle for a few seconds, which could be an indication that someone's thinking of leaving. To do that, just go to Time, Idle Seconds on Page, and choose the amount of seconds. We usually go with 3. And last but not least, let's make a Lightbox that appears on any page with the same tags. Let's say you wanted to show a specific Lightbox on all of your products by a specific brand. Except you don't have the brand name in your URLs, so you can't use the URL contains rule we talked about before. But you do have every product page tagged with brands. Awesome. scroll down to content, and choose the HTML exists jQuery rule. Then you want to go to your website, right-click on the tag you want, and click inspect to open up your DevTools. Then right-click on the tag in the HTML code and go to copy and choose copy selector. And paste that into your conditions field, hit save and publish. Now this lightbox will appear on any page with that same tag. There are tons of other things you can do with conditions, but this was just a brief overview of some of the most common uses.